Lifetime on Action Central Wrestling, Eve Tarleton demanded respect, and our AEW Women's Champion, Gloria Baz, forced her to earn it by competing against her in a one-on-one contest. After Eve Tarleton picked up the victory, she wanted to fight Kimiko. However, Carolyn Amber and Angelina Spears made other plans, attacking Kimiko and Eve. How will Carolyn perform against Gloria Baz? The Lucky 16 tournament rolled on, and Johnny Rivers and RJ Miles defeated the team of Austin Kazarian and Brian Dexter. With Brian Dexter having a big-time matchup against Lorenzo Sampson, how will his previous loss affect his performance? Shawn Wright picked up a tremendous victory over Seth Byrne, but CTP's Lorenzo Sampson once again left Shawn Lang ahead of their global championship encounter at Mission X. The Cabal can successfully cross off Team Wicked from their hit list as they were victorious against Team Wicked members Forsaken and Chaos. Uriel of No Limit explained the purpose of their mind games against the Twisted Disciples, that motive being revenge. But before they could make their challenge for a six-person tag, Draven proposed a challenge of his own. A number one contender, three-way dance for the Tag Team Championship, who will go on to Mission X to face the ACW Tag Team Champion. Nate Shields picked up a victory despite a tremendous performance and outing from Andre Richardson. Following the matchup, Nate Shields made a vow to destroy Darren Tarleton and to finish what was started between these two individuals, even going as far as to take things to Darren's personal location. These words did not sit too well with his Lucky 16 tournament partner and the brother of Darren Tarleton, Destry, who made a vow that outside of the professional wrestling ring, family come first. How will the threat of Nate Shields affect their chemistry as they continue on in the Lucky 16 tournament? Finally, Top Class Warriors had a successful night as they destroyed A2J and Jackson Wade successfully defeated Adrian Oxley. Mr. Bloomberg has one more task, and that is for the destruction of Jake Havoc. Can Havoc pull off a miracle and a 4-on-1, no disqualification, handicap match against Top Class Warriors? Find out as ACW begins now. Following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Toledo, Ohio, weighing in at 220 pounds, Mack Wolf. Well, ladies and gentlemen, what is up? It's your boy JNW Boss in the building, back here for another episode of Action Central Wrestling. And given the massive night that we are about to have, we're just going to get right into things here. We're going to get right into the action, and we're going to kick things off with Mack Wolf going one-on-one with Shawn Wright. And we heard Mack Wolf earlier in the week saying how confident he is in his ability to defeat Shawn Wright, telling Shawn Wright that he hasn't faced anyone like Mack Wolf before. And granted, need to have been in the ring with each other before, but Mack Wolf is pretty keen on telling him how different this time is going to be. So we're going to see how Mack Wolf does here. Out here, ready to rock and roll right here in Reno, Nevada tonight. It's going to be a great one. We're going to run down the card following this opening matchup here. And here comes our ACW Global Champion, Mr. Shawn Wright, who definitely had an interesting past couple of weeks here on ACW. He's been on a roll, I will admit, as well. We're going to get into that momentarily. Good tonight. AEW Global Championship around his way. Can he keep it at Mission X, though? That's the question. And his opponent from Seattle, Washington, weighing in at 215 pounds, he is the current AEW Global Champion, the Nightmare, Shawn Wright. Shawn Wright makes his way to the ring. As I mentioned before, Shawn Wright has been on a roll over the past few episodes. He's defeated CTP, Damian Miles. He's defeated both members of Wolfpack and Alexander Spike and Seth Byrne in separate one-on-one matches. But the common content with all of that is after every single match, he had to deal with Lorenzo Sampson, who has twice now laid out Shawn Wright. First time he was saved by Brian Dexter, there was nobody saving him last time around. And so Sean, I'm pretty sure in the back of his mind, is always thinking about Mission X and thinking about how important that match is going to be, especially since as of this moment, Lorenzo Sampson is still not signed with ACW despite him saying he's going to sign. But regardless, here we go. Mack Wolf and Sean Wright, and this matchup is underway. And once again, I would like to welcome you guys to another edition of Action Central Wrestling on the road to Mission X. We are got about 4 episodes to go until that pay-per-view takes place. And so, ladies and gentlemen, if you feel so inclined, feel free to click the like, comment, and subscribe, and also click the bell icon. That way you don't miss another upload, and feel free to use the hashtag, this one right here, ActionCW, to talk about the show on Twitter. And hopefully everybody's going to be talking about the night we are going to have. I mean, first off, Sean and Mack Wolf are kicking it off in a great way here. And Sean almost picked up the win right there. We would have been talking about how quick Sean beat Mack Wolf, but then again, we might be able to say the same for Mack Wolf, but Sean was able to kick out right there. And again, we're going to go over the card following this matchup, but bear in mind, we do have the Lucky 16 tournament continuing. And we have a three-way dance, our tag team number one contender three-way dance in our main event. It's going to be an incredible contest. Right now, let me just go ahead and give these two guys the proper respect they deserve. They are kicking us off with a tremendous, tremendous show of speed, tremendous show of athleticism, and ring awareness. And look at that, great awareness on the part of Mack Wolf, able to catch Sean coming in. And look at this, trying to go for a drop kick. Not able to happen, and Sean puts him down. I think that's the beautiful thing about when it comes to, you know, when it comes to matches like these two, matches like this here. I mean, you have a guy in Sean Wright who, I mean, talk about a guy who's really improved from his days in All Out Action. And you want to talk about a guy, Mack Wolf, who has, you know, now seen the main event, how he now knows what being in the main event is like. Being a former NBW World Champion. Coming so close to winning the All Out Action World Championship back at Breaking Boundaries in the Triple Threat. So talk about two guys that have really elevated their game in tremendous ways. And now here in ACW, we've seen what Sean Wright is able to do. We've seen what Mack Wolf is able to do. And Sean Wright might pick up the win here. But no, he does not. And Mack Wolf, the only matchup he has right here to his credit in ACW is the Lucky 16 tournament, where granted, you know, him and Jane Black lost that matchup, but just imagine the opportunity that awaits them at Mission X. Not only the opportunity that awaits them at Mission X, just imagine where a career can go if he can pick up a win here tonight. Oh, man. And Sean isn't going to make that one easy. They're not kicking his man's head off with that one. I'm going to follow up, boot to the midsection, and here we go. Up over the top, let drop right through the back of the net. All right, and then a bag now. This is where Sean is dangerous, man. This dude likes to take off and fly, go for that elbow drop. Got it right across the chest. Right across the chest. Right across the midsection. Putting in work is Sean Wright. Straight into a cover here. Sean might have it in the way to now. Look right there to the spine by Sean. Sean now. He's going to continue his offense here. Here we go. Going for this. Face buster again. It worked the first time and it worked the second time, and there's some moves that are great to have in your arsenal. Sean showing it right there. Mack Wolf is now back up to his feet. Here we go. Oh, look at that. Trying to go for a DDT. Didn't work. Now trying to catch him with a clothesline. That didn't work, but look at that. Mack catching him with a Hurricane Rana. Worked like a charm. Mack now sending Sean off into the corner. Couple of jabs. A fifth jab right there. Now got Sean up on the top rope. This is not a good play for Sean to be, especially since he isn't on offense here. Look at Mack Wolf. Oh, man, what a bulldog off the top. Robin Sean face first into the mat. Straight into a cover here. Oh, and a kick out at two. The very innovative offense on the part of Mack Wolf. Oh, man, to keep things in his favor. Went to Gary right to the spine. Talk about really, you know, shaking things up here. Now what? Here we go. Look at that. The fifth one. Driving down. Sean right here. Sean is in a world of trouble. And this matchup over the past couple of minutes has been all Max Wolf. And oh! What a grief. Driving him head first into the mat right there. Now Max Wolf is on fire. Max Wolf is really kind of turning up the heat here. Off the rope. Oh! Beautiful work from Max. I mean, this dude is scary athletic, man. What a freaking athlete that dude is. Freaking athlete, man. The springboard 450. And they kick out at two again. That's Sean. I mean, this dude, Sean is showing his toughness. I mean, we've seen the toughness of Sean. Sean through again and again. And we've also seen Max Wolf do it, too. I mean, he won a freaking I Quit match against James Black. Right? And next level, taking a beating in the process. Two tough guys are not going to let this match slip away from them. And they're looking at all excellent count on the part of Sean. That trying to go for to kick Sean's head off there, but that's not happening. And Sean getting able to dragon screw him and have a single leg Boston crab. Mack Wolf, he needs to get out of this thing or get it up. Sean now. He needs to collect himself here in the corner. Let's look for him. Driving him down again. Look at it. Oh, wow. Second time in a row, Mack with that move right there. Is it going to work? No. And Mack is getting a little bit frustrated. I'm sure Mack knows better than anyone, but you got to control your emotions in there. You really don't want to, you know, get too upset, get too in your feelings. You kick yourself slipping. I mean, we've seen it happen time and time again. But Mack Wolf, doing a smart thing, not letting his emotion get the best of him. And what an insecurity to the back of Sean's head. Sean just, oh, man. Oh, my word. He caught him with that kick this time. He's going to put him away. No. Fast-paced start here in this one. But the question is Mack going to be able to bring it home? Here we go. All right. Stopped in front of him. Oh, a sling blade. Good adjustment on the part of Mack Wolf. Made me realize he had something better in mind. And he put it to good use. And now Mack to go to the top row. Oh, he was probably thinking about that full moon. Sean well aware of that. Gets back up to his feet. Here we go. Off the top. Hurricane Rana. Down goes Mack. Down goes Mack off the Hurricane Rana. And now Sean is back in his wheelhouse. Here we go. Oh, a dragon cutter. Down he goes. Down goes Mack Wolf. And now Sean can cook with gas here. Oh. Cook with propane. That's the more popular thing to say. But you get my point. Sean, take it off, baby. Someone's not done. And the trend of guys trying to set the tone continues here at ACW with this one. John Wright, springboard dropkick right to the face. Gonna try to pin him off of that. I don't blame him. Is he gonna have it? Two. Ah. So close from the part of Sean. But Sean, don't worry. He still got the Nightmare Unleashed in the arsenal, and he still got that Silent Dream super kick, which Sean has made great use of over the past few episodes here. Winning literally almost all of his matches with it. So there you go. I'm sure Mack Wolf are going to be well aware of that. But right now, Sean's going to go for a springboard moonsault. Didn't really work. Great athleticism, though. Great form. But Mack Wolf a step ahead of the game. Uh-oh. Wait a minute. Look at this. Oh, a suplex there. Driving down Mack Wolf. Mack Wolf tried to get back into this one. But Sean is on one here. Off the rope go Mack, hip toss. Referee kind of going in and checking on Mack here. And that was a pretty rough landing there on the part of Mack. So good job on the referee to use a little bit of discretion there. Looks like everything's all good. And the elbow drop right to the midsection. Back to the outside again. Springboard again, elbow drop. Is he going to do it again? Yes, he is for the third time. Jeffy's going to be canned, man. I mean, when Sean gets in his bag, man, it's hard to stop him. That much I can promise you. This dude is great. He's doing some great stuff here. Going now, Colin Mack up to his feet. How is he going to do? Here we go. Oh, Frank Gunner again. Down he goes. Hard and on to the A-game. Y'all may be able to finish the one right here. He got in the distance. He may go for that Silent Dream super kick. Ah, no, maybe trying to go for that DDT. Oh, couldn't get it. Trying to go for the clothesline. Mack can't get it. Here we go. Tornado DDT. He got it that time. Beautiful. Sean has been cooking over the past couple of minutes. And this might be the end of Mack Wolf's night here in ACW. Sean waiting on him to get back to his feet. Silent Dream super kick miss. Silent Dream super kick miss. Excellent combination from Wolf. Mack Wolf got Sean in trouble. Knee strike. Jumping knee strike there from Mack, who thinks he got one more opportunity. He's going to look to make the most of it. He's climbing to the top. Is he going to hit the full moon? Is he going to hit it? Crowd here in Reno is waiting to see what he does here. Here we go. Go for the full moon. He couldn't get it. Sean, oh, Silent Dream super kick. Max reach. Sean made him pay. Nightmare unleashed, jumping him on the top of his head. The Nightmare unleashed. Well, the Canadian Destroyer dumping Mack Wolf, and Sean picking up the victory, man. What a performance from both men. Here we go. Take a look at kind of the final moments of this matchup. It seems that these two men were jockeying for position, but Sean able to get him with the DDT. And then right here pretty much summed it up. He tried to go for the full moon. And I guess it almost set into Mack that he was about to get clapped when he turned around, and he did. Then the Silent Dream super kick and the Nightmare unleashed. And it spelled a wrap for Mack Wolf, but what an outing from Mack. He got nothing to be ashamed of. Here's your winner, Sean Wright. And with that win, Sean Wright again continues his role. You know, for all the talk about Lorenzo Sampson or whatever, Sean got this. Sean is cooking with gas here. And I know Lorenzo Sampson handling some CTP business over there, prepping for CTP Forgiven, I believe. But regardless, Sean here on ACW handling it, holding it down.
Sean, congratulations. No, seriously, congratulations. You defeated Mack Wolf, a man who is a former world championship contender in All Out Action. That's great. That's really great. And for the first time, I'll admit, Sean, that you have impressed me in a great way inside that ring. But let's see if you can even bring half of that at Mission X. And I say half of that, Sean, because it's going to take more than what you did to Mack Wolf tonight to beat me. It's going to take more than what you've done against Alexander Spike and Seth Byrne to beat me. In fact, let's tell the whole truth. It's going to take more than what you did at End of an Era to beat me. Because there's levels to this thing, Sean. You can already see it. You walked in. You looked at the match card. You saw that you were second. You see that I'm second to last. Because, put it plain, Sean, I am a second to none talent. There is a reason Mr. Bloomberg is wanting me to put pen to paper so bad, and there's a reason why, to tell the whole truth, Mr. Bloomberg is wanting me to beat you for that global championship. What? Because, to be honest with you, man, he knows, and just like everybody else is going to know, that with me as the global champion, ACW goes to the next level. ACW goes to the top. And so Mission X, Fresno, California, I'm going to take my place at the top. But until then, you get to watch firsthand what it's going to be like. Because Brian Dexter, you and I finally collide one-on-one. Enough attacking each other, enough laying each other out. No, we get to meet in that ring one-on-one for the very first time. And Brian, as good as you are, as impressive, as powerful as you are, I'm just that better. You can say that I'm God. And you're going to learn that tonight. And Sean, you're going to learn that Mission X. Take notes.
Samson is rather competent in his ability to beat Brian Dexter. We're going to see if he can do it. Because it will be Lorenzo Samson finally taking on Brian Dexter. I've been waiting for this matchup for a long time. And then Carolyn has been waiting for this matchup ever since End of an Era. Carolyn Amber finally gets her hands on Gloria Bath. How is Carolyn going to do this time around? And then in the biggest case of power tripping I've ever seen, Jake Havoc takes on Top Class Warriors in a 4-on-1 no disqualification handicap match. Can Jake pull off a miracle? And in our main event, the three-way Dan for the number one contendership for the tag team titles, XD and Draven versus the Cabal versus Okada Jr. and Uriel in No Limit. But coming up next, it is the Lucky 16 tournament as Reaper and Dave takes on Alec and Riley Bloomberg. Ladies and gentlemen, if we can, get your stopwatches out. Get your stopwatches out. I'm predicting 5 minutes. Because, well, then again, I may be judging prematurely. We haven't seen Riley Bloomberg. We haven't seen what Riley Bloomberg can do. The son of Mr. Bloomberg, by the way. We haven't seen what he can do. So, we're going to get the chance. I might be wrong. The following contest is the final first round match in the Lucky 16 tournament, scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from the other side of darkness, weighing in at 297 pounds, Reaper. Well, Reaper makes his way to the ring. I'm sure he is looking to cause absolute destruction because of his, well, he always looked to do that. But Reaper so far has been successful here in ACW as he defeated RJ Miles a couple of episodes back. And destroyed RJ and Johnny Rivers after the fact. So we've seen a little bit of what Reaper and Dave can do. We've also seen, for those that followed All Out Action, we know how tough, how powerful, how intimidating Reaper can be. But I guess the only real blemish on this man's pedigree is that he has not won any type of championship gold yet in his career. That's really the only blemish I can say about this man. However, his partner, Dave, is a former All Out Action world champion. And you know good and well he's going to want to get back to the top and become the ACW world champion. We're going to see if he can get that done. I mean, both of these men, they gotta win a whole gauntlet in order to do that. And one of these two men can earn the 16th spot if they win the tournament, and then whoever beats each other. And introducing the partner from Manhattan, New York, weighing in at 323 pounds, Dave. Now, Dave and Reaper got the potential to be the scariest team in this entire tournament. Here's why. Actually, no, they got the potential to be the scariest or the worst team in this tournament. Both of these two men want championship gold. Dave wants the ACW world title, odds are. Reaper more than likely going to want to gun him for the same thing. But these two big men got to find a way to work together and win this tournament, because if they win this tournament, they can only then face off with each other and the winner gets a 16th slot. So we haven't seen any team fall apart just yet. But hopefully, I mean, if you're Alec and Riley, you're hoping these two big men butt head.
And the opponent, first, from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, weighing in at 220 pounds, Alec.
Alec making his way down to the ring here. When he was announced for this Ultimate Mission Gauntlet match, I felt it made a lot of sense. I mean, Alec right now has pretty much moved on from Draven. He's moved on from Brandon. All of his path is now behind him. So he can now move forward for real this time as his own man. And so he gets a great, I guess, opportunity to do that as he faces Dave and Reaper in a first ever ACW matchup. And I'll say, some way to make your performance here of your Alex and Riley respectively. But we're gonna see how Alex can do. Alex a tough cat. I'll give him that one. He's good. Alex is good. Cocky, too cocky for his own good, but he's definitely good. That much I will say. And here comes Mr. Riley
and his partner, making his professional wrestling debut.
His what?
From Davenport, Iowa. Weighing in at 243-pound Riley Bloomberg.
Wait a minute. Wait a whole minute. His professional wrestling debut? So you're telling me this dude haven't even wrestled a match anywhere? His professional wrestling debut? Wait a sec. Okay. What? So wait a minute. So Mr. Bloomberg hired his son that never wrestled anywhere? His professional wrestling debut. I've heard people making their ACW debut. I've heard people making a company debut. Oh, good. Well, the Reaper boot to Alex. Now the Reaper, this may be done. This right here may be finished. They might not even need to get in this matchup. Riley now trying to, Riley going to get back on the apron, but the Reaper's boot again. Reaper's dragging in Riley, or more like forcing him in. He gets them. Oh, this is, what the wall? Oh, tossing him to the floor. Oh my word. Reaper just ran through both of these men. Official, these two are probably going to be the scariest team in the tournament. Reaper didn't even need to tag Dave to win this one. Are you freaking kidding me?
Here's your winner, the team of Dave and Reaper.
Riley didn't even get in the match. Dave didn't even get a tag. What the? Oh, man. Oh, my word. Well, Dave and Reaper advances. And we're going to take a look here at the updated brackets, because that was quick. And, yeah, here it is. So, Johnny and RJ gets a little bit of chance of redemption here when they face Dave and Reaper. We're down to the final four teams. It's going to be Nate and Destry versus Nick and Jason, and then Johnny and RJ versus Dave and Reaper. After what we just saw between, Reaper solo, how in the world is Johnny and RJ going to prepare for any of that? Moving on to some women's action, as Carolyn Amber is about to, hold on. I can't even get my mind around how fast that was. That was the most one-sided tag team match I've ever seen in my life. And I saw many of them. Just saying.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by Angelina Speed from the Oakland Society, and representing the Twisted Disciples, Carolyn Amber.
Carolyn Amber making her way down to the ring here with Angelina Speed, that I hope that... How in the world did you lose that fast, bro? Good grief. Moving on. Carolyn Amber making her way down to the ring with Angelina Spears, who's been kind of an ally. These two have been allying with each other. We don't really know why. None of these two women have really expressed that. But what we do know, that Carolyn Amber has expressed her desire to become the ACW Women's Champion again. And I guess she got Angelina's help as her new friend to do that. And so we're going to see what these two or what Carolyn is able to do tonight against the ACW Women's Champion. And this is a rematch from End of an Era.
And her opponent, accompanied by Ashley Knight from Austin, Texas, she's the current ACW Women's Champion, Gloria Bat.
I think it's smart of Gloria Bat to not come out here alone, and the fact that she picked Ashley Knight to come out there with her is definitely saying something. And I will say this, if you are Gloria Bathy, you've been coming off of a loss to Eve Tarleton, and so now she got to deal with Carolyn Amber. Now Gloria been saying how she's been looking forward to this matchup, and even though she defeated Carolyn Amber before, so she does own a victory over her, I can understand the confidence there, and you know, and trusting your ability to do it again. But I think Carolyn, of course, not going to make it easy, but we're going to see how Gloria does in this one. And so far, this match has already lasted longer than our previous matchup that we just fought. Well, that's a good thing, at least. It's a good thing. It's a real good thing. Either way, though, Carolyn Amber now, look at it. Oh! Man. Dropping her down. And who do you guys think are going to win this one? Let me know in the premiere chat if you're watching. Let me know post chat if you're watching. And also, of course, you can talk about the show on Twitter. Action CW on Twitter. And look at it. Look at oh, man. What a German suplex there from Carolyn Amber. Different start, different approach than what we saw at End of an Era. More than likely because these two are more familiar with each other after that encounter, and the fact that they even were partners in a six-woman tag on the final episode of All Out Revolution. Big bomb dropping her down. And Carolyn now taking her time. Maybe she ain't got to be rush in with the women's champion and she's not going to. Carolyn now, oh my, that was. We're already in a lot of hot water here. Oh! He's driving her out to the floor. Ashley Knight trying to help her partner to her feet. Not a bad idea. Carolyn not going to let her go too much further than that. A belly on the floor this time. And Carolyn locking eye to eye with Ashley. And Carolyn did attack Ashley Knight back at End of an Era following her match, and again, maybe you can save the season that friendship will probably already plan it right then and there. And then matchup rolls on. Oh! Gloria in a massive trouble getting slammed into the barricade now, and now Carolyn going to continue to use the barricade as a weapon. Walking in the river in the count of seven. And Carolyn sending Gloria back inside the ring. Oh! They've been having a hard time getting out of the box here. They're going to go for a cover, but a little rope break right there. Rope kind of saving Gloria. Look out. Oh! Flashing. Look at that. Ooh. Now going for the cover. I think the thing is, I mean, Carolyn, she's smart. She's not stupid inside this ring. He really is. He's been in the ring with some of the best women around. Kind of applied her craft at the wrestler in NXT. There was a time where all that action didn't really have a women's division, but even over there for the short time that she was there, did great. Doing some great stuff. I mean, half them up and half them down, but she got back to all that action and started taking the fight to people. Came the AOA Women's Champion upon the division's return. She's actually the only woman to be a two-time AOA Women's Champion. On top of that. And down and hit her as the final all-out action women's champion, and then unfortunately took the loss to Gloria Bath at End of an Era, and hence why we're seeing this aggression out of Carolyn Amber right now. Look at that two right there from Gloria Bath, but Carolyn is just reveling this moment. She's been wanting this matchup. We finally get it. And it's clear she's not going to let this moment slip past her. We strike again. Puts her up for the... Think we can go for it again. We're going to send Gloria off into the corner. This is a good look. Oh, what a close. My word. Carolyn Amber is hitting on all cylinders tonight. And she's looking to continue her offense here. Look at this. Oh, excellent counter from Gloria. Gloria now with a cross body. Down goes Carolyn Amber. And this may be the opening that Gloria needed. ACW Women's Champion looking to fire back. Look at that. What a back suplex dumping Carolyn Amber on the back of her head there. Uppercut right there. Here we go. Full Nelson slam. Driving down Carolyn. There are a few people who can match Carolyn power for power, and Gloria is definitely one of those people that can. But now she's about to show her athleticism. That's from the leg lariat. Down goes Carolyn Amber. Gloria now going to the top rope. Here we go. Flash off the top. Excellent work right there. Great new accomplishment. They have it, Gloria. So close for Gloria, but not enough to put down Carolyn Amber. And she's got to continue the offense here. And if you're Gloria, the last thing you want to do is take another loss here. And we've seen it. Sometimes champions go on these, you know, these losing streaks, and then when the time comes for them to defend their title, they can't hang on to it. And then that leads to a whole other downhill spiral or trying to get back there, and some superstars are able to do it, and some can't, admittedly. And let's see if Gloria able to kind of, you know, buck the trend and buck that system. She gets a chance to do it by defeating Carolyn Amber here, but, oh, wait a second. Look at it. These two women are going back and forth here. Here we go. Got her up. Ah, excellent counter there. Right shot right to the back from by Gloria. Gloria now got Carolyn in a world of trouble. That scoop claim bringing her down. And now Carolyn going to, Gloria, I should say, going to continue with this power. Look at this. Look at this. Oh, man. Effective offer from Gloria. Flash off the middle rope this time. And they're probably trying to end it right there. I don't blame her, too. Look out from Carolyn. Look out. Oh, wow. And I'll say it this way. Gloria is showing how legit she is as a champion. And Carolyn is showing how legit she is as a competitor. It's clear that the tide of this matchup can turn on a dime between these two ladies here. Excellent athleticism on the part of Carolyn, but Gloria was ready. Gloria was ready to rock with the shoulder tackle driving down Carolyn Amber. Here we go. Gut wrench. Suplex. Beautiful. Beautiful gut wrench suplex. Down go Carolyn. Ready to recover here. She might have it. No. Kick out at two yet again. But Gloria has already proven that she can defeat Carolyn Amber. But Gloria's kind of just resorting back to what worked the first time around. And look at Angelina now helping up her new friend to her feet. And Gloria. Getting in the face of Angelina right there, but maybe by doing that, wasn't the wisest move, but Carolyn Amber, well, for a moment, we're getting back into things here, but Carolyn's able to counter. Here we go, look at this. Oh, ripped her right in the steel step. Really making use of your environment. Right to the midsection. Into a brawl in here. Oh, forearm sending Gloria up over the barricade. Now wait a minute, Carolyn gonna follow suit. These ladies might want to admonish themselves of that referee 10 count here. But Carolyn getting back in the ring, Gloria gonna follow suit. But Carolyn's right there on it. I wouldn't think Jenna goes for a shot there. Gloria there in the counter. Now she got Carolyn back in the corner. Just a shot here, not really hitting her target. I can't count on the part of Gloria. Here we go, off into the corner though, Carolyn. Gotta go for the consecutive flash. It didn't really work. Look at Carolyn. Oh, Lord, no, Gloria was able to get back into it. Excellent back and forth between these two women. Well, Carolyn way too close to the rope there. Here we go. Look at this. Belly to belly taking down Carolyn Amber. One of these women are going to have to hit the finishing blow if they can. One of the women are going to have to find the, you know, find the escape route to win this. What the world? Yo, look at this. Wheelbarrow. Neckbreaker from Gloria Bass. Excellent work. Never seen her really, hardly seen her use that move. Does it right there, but it doesn't get the win. Last time I saw that, Gloria, that move was a long time ago. Around the time she was just getting started in All Out Revolution. Gloria digging way back into a well for that one. Belly to belly again to Carolyn Amber. And now, look at this. Going up top. Here we go. The counter. Now this is not looking good for the women's champion. Oh, a gut wrench off the top. Man. Here we go. Backwards. That might be it. Oh. Nice. Nice work on the part of Gloria. Doing what she can to stay in it. Isn't it gonna last for too much longer? Carolyn hoping not. And she just caught him with that nasty discus clothesline. Got her up, going for that power. She couldn't get it. Gloria there with a counter. Referee get down there, bro. Two. Couldn't get it right there. Bulldog from Gloria. Clothesline. This has been good. Carolyn. Oh, got this splash again. Dodges that splash again. Over to the corner goes Gloria. Carolyn, Gloria dodges. Here we go. Oh, a face buster. Face crusher bringing down Carolyn. Here we go. Now what? Oh, forearm from Carolyn. These two women have been going back and forth. Blow for blow, shot for shot. Looking to hit a finishing blow here, but these two women can't seem to hit it. These two women have learned from each other in their previous encounter at End of an Era. Let me talk about a shot there again. Carolyn with a shot of her own. And the counter from Gloria. Here we go. Go for that fake crusher again. She got it. Thimble move that she went to. Went back to the well and got it. Carolyn Amber now. And in a heap of trouble. Up over the shoulder. She's going for that aerial crash. She's going to hit it. Gloria, Carolyn able to flip out of it. Spin her around. Go for that backbreaker. Gloria flipped out of that one. Off the rope. Drop kick to the knee. Talk about studying your opponent. Finally. Gloria able to hit these splashes in the corner. Puts her up overhead. Aerate crap bringing her down. Straight into a cover. This might be a wrap right here for Carolyn Amber. Are you kidding me? Gloria now even getting frustrated. Like, I don't know what the world else do I got to do? She got one move in her arsenal. If she can hit it, nope, she cannot. I thought she was thinking drop the bait. Couldn't get it. Gloria, Carolyn immediately catches her with the German suplex into the lariat. And now, this freaking powerbomb. Oh, that powerbomb of Carolyn Amber is just vicious. And Carolyn picks up the win. What a matchup, y'all.
This is about to close the moment, man. These two women were bringing it. Carolyn with them to catch Gloria with that German suplex into the lariat. And that just left Carolyn to hit that nasty powerbomb and the kind of the whiplash effect Gloria suffered right there, bouncing off the ropes and all, allowed for Carolyn Amber to pick up the win in this one.
Here's your winner, Carolyn Amber.
Carolyn Amber picking up the victory. What a matchup between these. Oh, wait a minute. I thought Carolyn was going to walk up the ramp. But it's pretty crystal clear. Carolyn got some unfinished business deal with Gloria Bass. I mean, we know she wants the ACW Women's Championship. But right now, this beatdown that she's delivering to Gloria Bass right now. Oh, no. Come on. Enough is enough. Oh, the powerbomb across the floor. Wait a second. Angelina ran over to the other side. Her and Ashley are now getting into it. Here we go. And these two are colliding ahead of Mission X here. Oh, and another steel step. I knew it was only a matter of time before things would have broke down between these two women. And look at this. Look at this. The GTS. The GTS, or the reverse GTS, I should say. Wait a minute. She counted. Oh! That's the Vought kick from Angelina dropping Ashley. Got her up overhead with the sister kick. Down goes Ashley Knight. Wait a second. Here comes Eve. Here comes Eve talking with the steel chair. Oh, and she cracked Carolyn over the head. Retribution from the last time around on ACW. And Carolyn Amber just got laid out from Eve. I don't even think Angelina realized what happened. She is the sister kick again to Ashley Knight, but Eve now with the steel chair. Gotta go for a shot there. Angelina trying to fight back here. Now Angelina's in a 2-on-1 spot. And that allowed for Eve Tarleton to bring the beat down on Angelina, getting a little bit of retribution here. Good grief. And now what? I think Eve is getting out of here. But she's gonna leave Ashley Knight to finish the job. With the GTF to Angelina. Wait a minute.
Well, wait a minute. It seems that things here in the ACW Women's Division have gotten a little crazy.
Christina Miller.
So, allow me, Assistant General Manager Christina Miller, to try to make things right. First off, Eve, you wanted to fight Kimiko last time around, but you didn't get the chance to because you were jumped by Carolyn and Angelina. Well, you're going to get that opportunity next week. You see, next week, I'm thinking it's you, Eve, going one-on-one against Kimiko. But maybe that's not the only time you share a ring with her. Because at Mission X, I'm thinking that it will be you versus Carolyn Amber versus Kimiko versus the ACW Women's Champion Gloria Bass in an elimination fatal four-way match for the ACW Women's Championship.
Wow!
And I think that is a fair solution to solve a whole lot of problems. So, lady, good luck.
Well, what an announcement from Christina Miller, an elimination fatal four-way for the women's title. Yes! Good work, Christina. I don't know how Mr. Bloomberg or the rest of management feel.
So I'm going to need you to explain this to me real quick, Mr. Bloomberg. I'm asking you for my match. I'm asking you for my due diligence and to face Jackson Wade, the man who attacked me and the man who tried to injure me. Also, the same man who set up A2J and brutally attacked Adrian Oakley for no reason. And you're, instead of allowing me to stand up for myself and some of my fellow colleagues, you're sitting there saying I'm not worthy enough?
To tell you the truth, Mr. Carter, that is exactly what I am saying. I do not think that you have demonstrated the physical and mental capability to be in the ring with someone the like of a Jackson Wade, as I feel that that match would be nothing more than a liability than an asset to ACW and the grand picture of Action Central Wrestling.
What?
You see, Nick, I am well aware that you were attacked by Jackson Wade, and I am also well aware how you were able to come back and win your lucky 16 tournament match with Jason Well. But I refuse to put you in any type of danger. However, if you are really brave enough and bold enough to face someone like Jackson Wade, then you will accept this next challenge. You see, next time on ACW, you will face a member of Top Class Warrior, and this will be a member that Jackson Wade selects. And if you win, I'll think about letting you have your match against Jackson Wade.
Stop gaslighting.
Well, about your match, I accept. But I know you've also been thinking about a lot of other things, too. You've been thinking about the health and well-being of Austin Wallace. You've been thinking about, in how many ways can I insert my son into a situation so he can have a better career. And what you've also been thinking about is ways to manipulate people that don't agree with you. Well, that's cool. Well, after tonight, you can add me to that list. And let's just say I'm well prepared for any consequence that comes from my actions.
Nick Carter, as he rightfully should be, is ready to go. And he wants somebody of Top Class Warrior. What type of gaslighting crap was that from Mr. Bloomberg? Then they're saying that that match will be a liability, then an asset to ACW? You smoking something? What is wrong with this guy? Nick Carter versus Jackson Wade is a match I want to see. Personally, I want to see this match. I mean, if Jackson Wade bold enough to put his hand on the son of a... If Jackson Wade is bold enough to put his hands on him, then I think he's worthy enough to get him in the freaking matchup. But ladies and gentlemen, we got to move on. Coming up next, it is the 4-on-1 handicap, no disqualification match, which is the biggest match of, which is the biggest ego stroke of Mr. Bloomberg I've ever seen. And I'm just going to keep it at that. I'm just going to be nice and keep it at that. Move on. All right, Jackson. Jack, what do you think?
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and it is a 4-on-1, no disqualification, handicap match. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 727 pounds, they are three members of Top Class Warriors, Johnny Evil, Simon Ortiz, and the leader of Top Class Warriors, Jackson Wade.
Now I have to ask myself this question. And y'all feel free to chime in with me wherever you guys may be watching. But if Jackson is as good as we know he is, I mean, he was a dominant All Out Revolution World Champion. And we've seen what he'd done against Adrian Oakley. Admittedly, he didn't really have help from Top Class Warrior to do what he did to Adrian Oakley for real. And we've seen how he did against matches with A2J and all this other stuff. If Jackson is as good as he says he is, why doesn't he go tell Mr. Bloomberg, screw you and your decision, give me Nick one-on-one? Why doesn't he do that? If you ask me, why? So now it's going to be him, Johnny Evil, who's on the middle rope right over there, and Simon Ortiz, who just took the other corner, versus, and Brandino, who's going to come out shortly because he wants to have his whole elaborate entrance and everything, versus Jake Havoc in a 4-on-1 handicap match. This is about to be the most absurd thing I believe we will ever see. I've never called a 4-on-1 handicap match today in my life. This is the biggest ego stroke I've ever seen Mr. Bloomberg do just to prove a point.
Y'all ever met somebody that like that they claim they're not a certain way, or they claim that they don't do something, but then they immediately have an action to prove that they are exactly what you were saying that they were? Yeah, this is that case. This is ridiculous. This is freaking ridiculous, man. All because Austin Wallace got hurt. It's professional wrestling. It happens.
And their partner, also representing Top Class Warriors from Philadelphia, weighing in at 220 pounds, Brandino.
Brandino makes it way to the ring. It, you know, I look at this guy and I think about the about his debut. I think about his debut at AOR's Live On pre-show all that time ago, and how he looked against Mr. Aaron Prince, a guy who's no longer, you know, with us anymore, or not he didn't pass away, but like he's no longer with us, no longer in, you know, ACW or anything. And I thought about how great of a competitor Brandino could be. But then himself, John Evil, and Simon Ortiz kind of threw all goodwill I had towards them away by outlining with Jackson Wade and doing his whole thing with Top Class Warriors. Ridiculous. And if Jake Cavett can pull anything off, I will be impressed. In fact, just by taking this matchup, Jake Cavett already got my respect. Just by taking this matchup, this dude got my respect already. Massively. Here come the anonymous one. This rock and roll, man. This is going to be something. And try not to get, you know, too angry during this matchup, because and their opponent from parts unknown, weighing in at 228 pounds, Jake Havoc. I'm gonna try not to get too angry during this matchup, because I know I got a job to do, and you know I gotta keep it professional to a certain extent. You know, I like to keep things, you know, kind of PG at least, you know, to a certain extent. But here comes Jake Havoc, a man who's getting this matchup. Because he, during his match with Austin Wallace, got himself intentionally disqualified to hurt Austin Wallace. Because Jake's goal is to get rid of corruption. And, well, a good way to do that is to go after the world champion who's allied with the freaking boss of this place. And you can't tell me that he isn't allied with him. Seriously. Not in the way Mr. Bloomer tried to protect Austin. It's ridiculous. But of course, he got no one out here to protect him, and here we go. Action starting this matchup off. And Jake Cavett, this is the first time these two competitors have ever faced off, and look at Jake Cavett. Look at Jake Cavett not backing down here. They're going to fight here to... They're going to fight here to Jackson Wade, and look at this. Oh! The Crusher bringing him down. Oh, wait a second, Simon Ortiz trying to jump in the mix. I don't know the best idea in the world, but here we go. Oh! And now look at this, now Brandino jumping in. Somebody need to get that fan out of here. Hey, oh! Close. This is somebody trying to jump in and got what they asked for. So there you go. Anyway, German suplex. All right, Brandino, here we go. Oh! Down goes Jake Havoc. And now, Cavett goes down at the hands of Jackson Wade. And of course, when you got 4-on-1, no disqualification, and the referee can't even administer a 5 count. And these guys could just jump in and do that all day long if they want to. And like that fan tried to jump in, and apparently tried to jump in the ring and got jumped for it. So there you go. Anyway, whatever. Scoop slam down little Jay Cavett. Whatever that goof is, we get him out of here. With an impaler DDT. Loving Jake Havoc right on the top of his head here. And then Johnny Evil, another great competitor, fantastic competitor. But him, Brandino, Simon Ortiz, allied himself with Jackson Wade. Oh! Loving Jake Havoc again with that impaler DDT. And now look. Network. Even a simple yet very very effective tag is made. Brandino is now legally in this matchup, and now apparently gonna change his mind, gonna tag in Simon now. And I wonder how the rest of Top Class Warrior feels about this matchup. I mean, I'm sure they're proud of their action by jumping A2J. I'm sure they're proud of their action by beating up Adrian Oxley, or by Jackson defeating Adrian Oxley. But now they got to do a 4-1 handicap. Now, oh, look at that. Brandino distracting the referee. Johnny Evil trying to jump in. Jake Havoc with him in a sidestep. Thank goodness for that. Northern Light suplex. Picks him up. Here we go. Right into a brain buster. Brandino is in the mix, of course. Throttling down with the Uranagi. Referee can't even administer a 5 count because this is all perfectly legal. And look at this. Sending Jake Havoc up over and dumping him to the floor. And by the way, there's no count outs as well. And now we're not about to do the thing of the new qualification of the still count out. No, there's no count outs here too. Well, there's that. Anyways, that's ridiculous. Back elbow right in the face. And look at this, that tiger foot like on the floor. These guys are so eager to hurt somebody that they're willing to stop their own partner from doing a move and say, no, hold on, I got something better in mind. And we just saw kind of a, that a little bit with Simon and even Brandino. Hopefully that doesn't lead to further tension for those guys, but I kind of hope it does. But nonetheless, 2 count. And Jake Havoc was able to kick out of that one. And prop to him. Again, end up in a 4-1 handicap. Who even thinks of that? What self-respecting man in power even thinks of that? Other than to prove an agenda. And the thing is, Jake Havoc did nothing to Top Class Warrior. That would be the thing. Jake Havoc did nothing to Top Class Warrior at all to end up in this matchup. His business will be Wilds and Wilders only. He right in the face of Johnny Evil. Havoc is trying to get some type of momentum. Boom right to the back. Here comes Brandino again. This time Jake Havoc fight him off. Talk about we rumble aware of your surroundings. Wait a minute, here comes Jackson Wade with a freaking big boot. Are you kidding me? This is going to happen all matchup. This is literally going to be the thing all matchup. Now Jackson Wade sending Jake Havoc to the floor. Third. Super kick over the third. Well, Johnny even going to sit back and watch this happen. Can be counted out and no disqualification. It's freaking impossible. How is anybody expecting to win this? Oh, right, he is. It's all done by Mr. Bloomberg just because he heard his little golden boy. All because they heard his golden child. Lord forbid somebody gets hurt within the confines of professional wrestling. It happened. Grudges happen. Beef happen. People get hurt. It happened. I'm in the corner of those Havoc tags made to Jack and Moore. We're double teaming. Down to the net breaker. Jack and Lee proud of himself. They're trying to recover, man. It's probably over right here. Of course. Because he literally couldn't pin him. No. No way he gonna pin this man and end this game right there. 4-1. I mean, to get kicked out with one thing, but he's really gonna pick this man's head up in a 4-1 handicap, man. That's ridiculous. Look at the fear call of David. Oh, wait a minute. I'm not gonna hit the spear, but Nick Havoc was able to leapfrog it. It could work. Dropkick, not dropping Jackson, but it's something. Dropkick again, not dropping Jackson, but it's something. Any offense is good offense in this case. Headbutt right to the skull. Here we go, dropping him off the tank. Got it again with this. Dang, got it again with this. Wait a second. Never mind, Simon off the rope. Dropkick dropping down Simon. Here comes Johnny. Trying to go for a spin kick, miss. Jake Havoc is on one here. Here we go. Suplex bringing down Johnny Evil and the Eagles landing to Brandon. Dang it, this is ridiculous. Froggy
Rocked him with a spear.
Pinned it. What?
What the world you need a chair for? What? Why the chair? This is a 4-1 handicap match. Bro, you pinned the man. You pinned him twice. You had your boy jumping. This is ridiculous. Spear the man and get spear him and get this thing over with. Thank you. Pin him. It's simple answer to a simple solution. Just pin the man. What are you tagging Simon for? Why does Simon need to be tagged in? Why? Literally, why does Simon need to be tagged? What is this? Thank you, Pinman. It's 4-1. Simon. What are they doing? They kind of get thrown into the corner. Splash in the corner from Simon. Hack to Johnny. What are y'all doing now? Oh, I know what this is. Target acquired. That's the name of that finisher for Johnny and Simon. Target acquired. Target connected with Jake Abbott's head. Thank you, Johnny. You have the presence of mind to end this crap. I mean, if we have to watch the final moments of this matchup, sure. Jackson being a self-egotistic. And then the damn chair. Why? Why the freaking chair, dude? Ladies and gentlemen, these were the most unnecessary minute of a matchup I've ever seen. 4-on-freaking-1 you have to do this? 4-on-1. I hope Mr. Bloomberg is happy. Mr. Bloomberg probably got the biggest smile on his face in the world.
Here's your winner, Brandino, Johnny Eaton, Simon Ortiz, and Jackson Wade, Top Class Warriors.
You know, my man Jackson said it best. Top Class Warriors, a bunch of low class Jackson. You know what? Let me chill. Top Class Warriors win. I'm going to take a breather.
Okay. I'm glad all three of you are in here, because somebody in here is probably going to have an answer for me. When is Darren's suspension going to be lifted? Because last time I checked, the stipulation was if I won at end of an era, which I did, that means Dwayne and I career are saved, and that Darren's suspension will be lifted sooner than expected, which means I am one step closer to getting the match that I've been wanting, me versus him. So, Mr. Ezekiel, Miss Miller, Mr. Bloomberg, somebody tell me when this new suspension is going to be lifted. First off, Mr. Shields, I don't know who you are walking into this office trying to demand anything. You are lucky you even have a job right now after you putting your hand on Mr. Ezekiel. So you better show some respect for one.
Yeah, Nate, I'm going to tell you the honest truth. He kind of right. I don't know what the world you think. You thought we were going to play ball after the way you decided to put your hands on me? You see, this wouldn't have happened. I would have made you versus Darren for end of an era had you not did all that. But since you did, you had to play hardball. And so, yeah, you won your match at end of an era, but I can promise you Darren's suspension will be lifted on our time. That is something that we can definitely agree on. Oh, come the heck on with this crap. Y'all sitting there playing around with me at this point. Actually, Nate, they're not. They are not playing around at all. And admittedly, Nate, I'm in full agreement with this. See, Nate, this didn't even need to happen. But you brought this on yourself. And so, when Darren's suspension is reinstated, we're going to then think about putting you two in a match against each other. But until then, I suggest that you keep doing what you're supposed to do and keep handling your business. You got a lucky 16 tournament you need to win with Darren's brother. I will focus on that right now. You know what? Fine. Cool. If the three of y'all want to be that way, fine. And you know, Mr. Ezekiel, specifically with you, it's a shame, bro. It's a shame you used to handle stuff like this. But now, you and Miss Miller over there, kissing this dude. But that's fine. Because I can promise you,
when Darren comes back, I'm handling my business. With or without you.
We're back.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, introducing first from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 287 pounds, Brian Dexter.
Back, ladies and gentlemen, with more ACW action. It is time for Brian Dexter to take on Lorenzo Sampson. And to address everything that happened with Nate just a moment ago, I was paying attention. And I'll say it this way. Nate, you kind of made your bed. Now you got to lie in it, man. Now, do I trust that Mitchell Bloomberg is going to do the right thing? Probably not. But the fact that he got two other people behind him, he probably is at some point. At some point, he is. And I think Nate's going to get what he asked for. But right now, it's time. Brian Dexter take on Lorenzo Sampson in a match we've been waiting on for quite some time. I mean, ever since the final episode of All Out Revolution. Of All Out Revolution. And Lorenzo Sampson attacked Brian Dexter from behind, and ever since then, ever since Lorenzo started making his presence known on All Out Revolution, Brian has been the guy that we're taking Lorenzo Sampson out of here, and hopefully he can do that again here tonight. Here comes Mr. Lorenzo Sampson himself. A man who will be challenging Sean Wright at Mission X in for the ACW Global Championship. And I really don't think his assessment of Sean Wright is as correct as he'd like to claim that they are. And introducing the opponent from Orlando, Florida, weighing in at 270 pounds, Lorenzo Sampson. Lorenzo Sampson makes his way now to the ring here. I mean, given that this is Sampson's one of the first matches here in CCP, I'll say it like this. If you are Lorenzo Sampson, this is a case of, out of all your actions, you better be able to back up everything you've done up to this point. You better be able to back up everything you say up to this point. Especially with what he said earlier of how he was saying that Mr. Bloomberg wants him, you know, to be in ACW, which I do believe. But he was also saying how if he wins the global championship, he can take ACW to the top. Okay, he just may. But the problem is right now, and up until this point, really right here, right now against Brian Dexter, you have not had a match here in ACW. Yes, you've had matches in All Out Action. I was about to say All Out Revolution, but it never got to that. But you've had matches in All Out Action, absolutely. You beat some of the guys there. But something about ACW has brought out the best in these competitors. Something about the two brands merging as one has brought out the best and maybe the worst in these competitors. And so we're going to see it now, how Sampson can hang, especially against someone the likes of Brian Dexter, who's been waiting on this match and even about to hurt Lorenzo Sampson. So ladies and gentlemen, this is our co-main event of the evening. Following this will be the three-way dance, number one contenders match. The winner will face the ACW attacking champion on Mission X. And right now, Brian Dexter is firing on all cylinders right here. Excellent work from Dexter, man. Vicious shot right there. Brian Dexter circling Sampson. Brian Dexter's going to kind of favor this moment. Again, this is something he's been waiting on. This is a moment he's been, this is a match he's been wanting to have. This is a match not only myself, but the others have been wanting to see. And we're finally going to get it here. Let's see how it goes, man. I'm curious. Neat. And I don't like Samson from the standpoint of, and then he called himself the hand of God. I highly disagree. But the second part of that is, you know, he walked around, he got this massive ego about him. You know, for someone that hasn't really, you know, made their mark here in AZW or even in All Out Action or All Out Revolution. Now to Samson's credit, like at World Collide, he did, first off, the whole thing behind, you know, why World Collide would even brought back was because of everything involved with him and his idea, and that was his brain cell, that was his motto. Then he went into World Collide and beat Reaper in his own environment in that Chaos Reign match, which elevated Samson's game. And over there on CDB is the current Greater World Champion. And CDB prepare for the Unforgiven event. Right now he got to handle Brian Dexter, and so far it's not looking too good for him. And they got caught with a massive back elbow there. And now look at it, Brian Dexter sending Samson flying up and over to the outside. And I'm sitting there talking about Samson's resume, Brian's resume. He's one of the fastest rising stars All Out Revolution had. Oh! Came in and within less than 10 matches, became the AZW Global, or became the All Out Revolution Global Champion. And then he lost it to Sean Wright, and I'm sure he wants to get that title back and probably go on to bigger and better things. Oh! But he is in the Lucky 16 tournament. He actually is in the, not the Lucky 16 tournament, he got eliminated from that. But he is in the Ultimate Mission Gauntlet match that will be taking place at Mission X. Just imagine what a win at that. Just imagine what a win like that would do. Oh! Good form. Samson can't get out of the box with this guy. He's calculating, man, for real. Not wasting any type of time at all. Here we go. Not a roll, jumping season. And that's with power, definitely something to not take lightly. His ability is not anything to take lightly. Especially when he starts getting in this type of bag right here. Oh, Turf Stomp driving down Samson. And Samson might go from a... Oh, wait a minute. I ain't going up top. What the fuck is this? I know he would go up here, but oh, he does it right there. Catches the moonsault beautifully. And across the rib. He got Samson in a water truck. Look at that, just manhandling my boy. Ryan, my boy, though, and he's making me feel a lot better. Brian Dexter putting in work. Brian Dexter is putting in work. That's what counted from Samson. You give credit where credit is due. Samson's a good athlete. Great athlete, even. I'll go far to say that. That's the other way. He carries himself, and the fact that he got no problem keeping understanding that Catholic is me, dude. It's all of that. It causes my problem. Now that's right. Let's see where this goes. Here we go. Look at this. Oh, man. Ripped off again. And Samson got cut open there. Yes, he did. Got cut open there off that curve top again. Your head smashed into that mat, man. That'll open up something. And it does it right there. And Brian Dexter, they go from zero to hero and take Samson with him, but never mind. Here we go, look at it. Oh, shot right there to the chest. Down goes Brian Dexter. Here we go, off into the corner. What about something that was needed? Get Samson to get back in this one. Boot right to the face. Down goes Brian Dexter. Look at the gut again. Look at this, Brian Dexter. In trouble here in the corner. Samson not letting him up. Not letting him out of this corner in the slightest. Look at it. Oh! Boot to the gut. And look at the strength of Samson here. Gut buster. Buster right there. Driving down Brian Dexter. This is something that Samson. Oh! Goodness. Wow! What a jumping knee strike from Samson. You know, I was there when he added that, you know, knee into his arsenal, a CPB takeover in Atlanta, because, you know, they wanted, you know, somebody to, you know, call the thing to know what they're doing over there. But
I saw when he added that move into his arsenal in Atlanta. I'm sitting there thinking that's a great move, and this is also a great yet very painful move. As Samson hits him with a DDT on the apron, and talk about ringing your bell. If you're Brian Dexter, man, this is going to be a massive uphill climb for Dexter. Here we go. Oh, going right to the barricade. Head first off the barricade again. Going to the barricade again. Head first off the barricade for the second time. And they're doing a smart thing, taking full advantage of the fact that we were able to get back in. They want to catch him with that DDT on the apron. Everybody has a count of seven. Hanson may try to go for the count out victory here. Why not keep yourself fresh for Mission X, I will say, but it will be a massive disappointment. But Brian Dexter able to get back to this one, but Hanson is right there with the knee. Oh! Four. Now we're seeing the striking ability of Lorenzo Samson taking full effect here. DDT. Robbing down Brian, straight into a cover hit. Samson may have it, but coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, it will be three-way dance. In our main event, three-way dance. First time ever we will have a three-way dance in AEW history. And All Out Action, All Out Revolution history. Never done something like this before. Hey, AEW, we're all about doing new things, baby. Stay tuned for that. Right now, these two men are bringing the fight to each other. Oh! Looking driver down, driving down. Brian Dexter here. Kick out at two. And if Samson thought it was going to be a cakewalk, he's kind of sad in the face. And if he thought he was going to be able to kind of run in and kind of run through Brian again, sad in the face. I think from how we heard his tone earlier, I think he knows what he's getting in for here with this one. And look at this. Oh! Right on the back of the neck. This is not a good look at all for Brian. Brian. Ooh. Hit for right into the ring post on the outside. And I like how my almost very calculated that Samson and Brian are. If you guys got a game plan and they're looking to stick to it and execute, who perfection to look at this. Oh, man, back suplex on the floor. Hangs on into a German suplex. Again, all of this is out here on the floor. Very thin padding out there. Look at this. Oh, a suplex driving down Brian. Over in the count of eight, tossing Brian back on the inside. I got something that would need it. Takes him up here. Oh, what a forearm. Nasty work. Nasty work with the forearm. Samson now going up top here. Don't have a whole lot of room. Is he going to hit it? Yes, he does. He's like a shoulder tackle. But it sends Brian crashing into the barricade. And now Samson going to follow up with a Uranagi across the thing. Samson is executing his plan. You perfection there. I don't know if that apron DDT was a calculated move or was just something that he needed to get back in this one. But either way, it worked out tremendously. And the offense that followed it almost got him the victory. But Samson now, his confidence isn't shaking. He's still going to continue to do the thing here. Here we go. Look at that tiger suit. Dumping him right on the back of his head and neck here. And now he's maybe sitting there thinking, they go for that hand of God. Can it connect? No. Oh! Brian Dexter was able to counter. Striking back. Getting back in this one here. Back to the outside. Goes Samson. And Dexter going to now follow suit. Maybe it's his turn to get some impact on the floor here. But not. Thought it was going to be Samson's turn to maybe feel that barricade and to feel the everything that... Oh, man, that he was doing to Brian on the floor. But Brian going to get back in the ring. He's going to stay. He's going to, you know, keep cool, keep him to himself. Brian Buster and high. Kick out at two. That was close. Real close. Got to applaud Brian Tucker. But you got to applaud Samson, too. How much I will admit, you got to applaud Samson. He
wrestled his way back into this matchup. And he almost, depending on where that was about to go, he may have lost that matchup, but look at this. German suplex. Here we go, right into a dragon suplex. And look at this. Look at Brian Dexter right into a straitjacket German suplex this time. May have him right here off of this one. No, he does not. Look out at two, Brian Dexter. He's feeling drained here. This match has been draining for both participants. Is it going to pay off here? Is it going to pay off for all? No. No counter there from Samson. This fight continues here. Here we go. Look at it. Oh, mountain head first. Right off the top turnbuckle. And I believe Brian busted open. Yes, he is. The men are bleeding. And a battle between these two men. Up to the top rope goes Samson. Right hand. Wait a minute, what the word is that? Oh, look at this. Look at Samson countering. Shoving Brian off. And oh, what a back senton from Samson. Back senton from Samson. Now Samson going back up to the top rope again. Now he's feeling confident. Now he's feeling confident, but he may feel a little bit too confident. And Brian Dexter's getting back in this one. And now we're going to try round two of this. Wait a minute, what the world? Look at this. The face buster off the top. Man, beautiful work. Double underhook face buster connects. And, he couldn't get it. He couldn't get it. But very effective on the part of Brian Dexter. Here we go. Curb stomp, he got him. And now, he may set up for the zero to hero if he can get it. Zero to hero to Lorenzo Samson, yeah. Yes, he got it. He got it and going for the cover. Does he have it match one? No, he does not. I thought I heard the ref hand hit three. Brian is livid. He thought that was every minute of a three count, and I don't blame him. Man, that was close. He's not going to let that stop him. He's going to continue with offense. German suplex. Down goes Samson. Picks him up. Oh, what a boot right there. What a boot right in the face. Brian Dexter got Lorenzo Samson in his sight. Counter from Samson. Here we go. Excellent reversal from Brian. Samson gets right back up to his feet. Oh, look at this. He was probably thinking about that power driver, but he didn't get him. Brian, what's he going to do? He's thinking about his next move. He's going to go up top. I don't blame him. Here we go, going for the moonsault again. Oh, we got him. I thought he got him. He got him. Got him with the moonsault. Straight into a cover here, too. You count right there. But notice how Brian's confident isn't shaking either. It's almost like, all right, I was ready for that. And if you get up from it, fine. I'm going to keep bringing the fight to you. Curb stomp, down goes Samson. And this might be it. If he can hit that zero to hero one more time, it's probably going to be over. He's looking like he's going to line up for it. Let's see. Whatever it was. Samson was able to counter. Oh, wait a minute. Sending Brian off the rope. Pops him up. Oh, he caught him. Popped him up. Caught him. With the hand of God right there. And now that power driver spiking him down. Talk about getting your, talk about out of nowhere stuff. Samson just exemplified that, dropping him on his head again with that power driver. Straight into a cover. Wait a minute, Brian's hand may be up in the bottom rope there. If it was, it doesn't matter. Samson picks up the win. I mean, let's take a look at the final minutes of this matchup. I thought Brian Evans wanted the bag, but popped up and got caught with the end of the guy right there. And then these two pile drivers by Lorenzo Sampson spelling it all, spelling the finish for this matchup and the victory for Lorenzo Sampson. As much as I want to hate it, because Sampson's a CTP guy.
Here's your winner, Lorenzo Sampson.
And as much as I want to hate Lorenzo Sampson for him being a CTP guy, I can't really dispute this performance that we just saw from him. He got out-wrestled in the beginning, and the way he wrestled his way back into this matchup and catching Brian Dechter off guard, leading to the two pile drivers, it's going to be stuff like that that's going to make Sampson a very dangerous challenger at Mission X. And speaking of challengers, Gloria Bath, as of tonight, has three hungry challengers for the ACW Women's Championship. It is Gloria defending her title against Carolyn Amber, Eve Tarleton, and Kimiko. And we just saw a thing kind of break down between Carolyn and Eve. How is it going to fare at Mission X? And then we also saw a thing kind of break down between these two, Ashley Knight and Angelina Spear, following Carolyn's match with Gloria. Angelina Knight was looking to get revenge on Angelina for the attack on Chloe in her return to ACW. Can Ashley finish things once and for all with Angelina? And then we just saw Lorenzo Sampson pick up a tremendous victory against Brian Dechter. And we saw Sean Wright pick up a win against Max Wolf. These two guys are on a collision course. Two unstoppable forces looking to collide for the ACW Global Championship. And please, Lorenzo Sampson, sign the contract before Mission X. Anyway, moving on, we also have the ACW World Title. A2J, Austin Wallace, and Jackson Wade. Jackson Wade and Top Class Warriors have been running absolute ruckshot. And if they do anything of that sort leading into this ladder match, Austin may not have that world title anymore. But we know how sneaky Austin is. And we all know A2J is a massive fighter. And we're going to see who earn a shot at the ACW World Championship in the Ultimate Mission Gauntlet match. 16 men with one massive opportunity under Fall Count Anywhere rules. So, who can win the Ultimate Mission Gauntlet match and receive their ACW World Title shot? And with all that out of the way, it is three-way dance time, a.k.a. our ACW main event. The following contest is your ACW main event, a three-way dance, where the winner will receive an ACW Tag Team Championship match at Mission X. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 454 pounds, the team of Okada Jr. and Uriel No Limit. Now, No Limit have done some very, very questionable things over the past couple of weeks. From attacking Colin Kane to distract the Triple Disciples, to then go as far as to insinuate that they attack Carolyn Amber, the level that these two men are going to try to get back at the Triple Disciples is absolutely, it's brilliant in a way, but it's also like kind of sick at the same time. I don't know how I feel about these two guys. These two guys were a part of All Out Action for a brief time. They had their debut against the Twisted Disciples and lost in brutal fashion. And these two guys came back on a mission to get some revenge and think to say they've gotten it. But now they got to earn their spot here in this three-way dance. This is the first time we've seen Uriel and Okada Jr. in tag team action since their debut on All Out Action. The record of All Out Action episode 50. Here come one of the newer teams to the group. And Draven, it was his idea. He wanted to dance. He said, let's dance together. He's going to get it. I hope Draven doesn't regret what he asked for. And Draven, what the heck is his partner? Draven coming out here by himself? Oh, there he is. I don't know where the man was. Oh, is everything good? There they are, man.
Ultimate Correction.
And their opponent, at a combined weight of 413 pounds, representing the Ultimate Correction, Draven and FD.
Well, the Ultimate Correction debuted the previous episode in a six-man tag against Colin, or two episodes ago, I should say, against Colin Kane, Ace Stone, and J.A. 3, a part of the Switcher Disciples. And they picked up the victory, to admittedly to my surprise. But again, it was kind of due to the assistance of No Limit, which Draven did acknowledge. And so Draven and XD and the Ultimate Correction in general have not wasted time and talk about a massive opportunity if you are the Ultimate Correction. You come in, you beat the tag team champion, and now you get the chance to compete. You get a number one contender match if you win. You get a shot at the tag team title. It can turn out great for the Ultimate Correction. But also, they also have to deal with this team right here. And their opponent, at a combined weight of 420 pounds, the team of Eldridge and Ryan Rage, the Cabal.
Now the Cabal has been looking to get back on top of the mountain. They were the first ever All Out Revolution Tag Team Champion. They lost it in their very first defense to Brandon and Alex. And ever since then, they've been looking to get back into championship hunt. And so far, they've been doing that successfully. They beat the Twisted Disciples. Again, due to the distraction of No Limit on the very first episode. Then, they made the challenge to Forsaken and Chaos of Team Wicked, and well, since Reaper was, you know, busy doing the Lucky 16 tournament stuff, and they won. Straight up, they won. And so now, they get inserted into this three-way dance offered by Draven, crazy enough, but they get inserted into the three-way dance nonetheless. So talk about one more step to, you know, to reach immortality for these guys, but then they got to beat the Twisted Disciples again. And that's not going to be an easy feat, and I think that's the thing all three teams did need to kind of realize. I mean, the winning team faces the Twisted Disciples at Mission X, man. That's going to be an uphill battle. And just like this, three-way damn is going to be an uphill battle. And if you watch it to this point, thank you. If you haven't done so already, feel free to click the like, comment, and subscribe, and click the bell icon to be that miss another upload again. If you've enjoyed, use the hashtag ACW. Or Action CW to talk about the show on Twitter. And we're going to get kind of chaotic here. I'm going to do the best that I can. So Ryan Rage to kick down Yoriel, and Ryan Rage is going to put a stop to whatever Mr. XD is doing. And now the Cabal is going to go to work on Yoriel and XD on one side. Look at this triangle choking locked in. And rolled up a three-way dance. Last team standing remains. Elimination of the curve by pinfall or submission. Both team members would have to be pinned with the middle in order for the team to be eliminated for this match here. And here we go. Look at this. Look at Draven. No. Oh! Excellent job to get Ryan Reeves in the corner, catching him in the floor of mine. They're covering the matchup. They're just kicking out like a one count. And it's a chiropractor right there from Draven. And look at Uriel getting involved. Letting his partner from being pinned right there. Pinning back with. Down goes, or to the out, to the apron goes Yorio. Oh! Draven dropping into the outside, but Draven now getting dumped over. And now inside the ring, O'Connor Jr. stuck to the outside. You got Eldrace and Mr. XD continuing their fight. Look at this. Oh! That's close line right to the back of the head. And you see, oh, look at that. You see Mr. XD looking to the outside. And O'Connor Jr. and Yurio are putting in work to Draven. But he got to deal with the Cabal now, jumping him on the inside of the ring. Look at this. Oh, man. Now goes Mr. XD. Mr. XD now in a world of trouble here against the Cabal. 2-on-1 situation. Right there to the back. And for XD, I mean, we saw how impressive he looked in that six-man tag. He had some great offense, but the question is he going to be able to hang with the Cabal? And that, and look at this. He was able to dodge Eldridge and able to dodge Ryan Reyes. Good work there. Good work. Dude is a loser. XD now going to the top rope. Look at this. Oh, that elbow. Excellent elbow to Eldrick, dropping him down. Right into the fencing over there. Look at this. Oh, face first. Out goes Eldrick right on the ramp. And wait a minute. Right leg. Getting involved, the forearm right to the face, but look at that knee getting right back into things here. Here we go, gonna spin him around. German suplex, dumping him right on his head. And that knee sees what's happening on the other side of the ring. He's gonna go help his partner here. And again, the beatdown is continuing by no limit. Way to wear out Draven on the floor. Oh no. Oh no, this is not a good look right here. This is not, oh man. Dropped him net first. Where the heck? Oh, now there he is. I wonder where the heck Mr. XD was. I saw him running. But there he is, taking out both members of No Limit. Now Okada Jr., now he's grabbing Uriel, putting them back inside the ring here. And now allow Draven to kind of get a little bit of reprieve, at least for the moment. Oh, but Uriel puts him down, and now XD finds himself in a 2-on-1 spot again. Unfortunately, Draven is making his way back to his feet. After he counted the kick from Uriel, he hits the gurn. And I think that's the beautiful thing that Ultimate Correction picked up on pretty early. You gotta watch your partner's back in a match like this. If you get eliminated, man, ain't no saving you after that. And look at this. You're not good. Oh, man, dumping him on his neck again. XD trying to make the save. Excellent forearm right there. Clothesline to the back of the head of Okada Jr. And fortunately, Draven was able to kick out. Now McLuck being on a roll here, but Uriel putting a stop to that. Wait a minute. Ooh, I'm going to let you the. Here we go. Look at this. 619 around the ring poke to XD. Draven now in a world of trouble still. Still kind of a bit vulnerable here, but look at this. No limit. Oh, man. High low. Taking down XD. Wait a minute. I don't know if I want to check on Draven for a variety of reasons, but this too. I might have a little something damage with the head and neck there after those two brutal moves from Yorio and No Limit. They burn control here. Here we go. This is a good look. Look at this. Oh, Yorio making fly. Beautiful. Beautiful work there from Yorio. Now they got Draven all by himself here. They're going to need to do something to get back in this thing. It's gonna be hard to, but you got No Limit double teaming you like this. No Limit is cooking. If the ball kind of laid out correctly, collecting themselves, they kind of crawled up the ramp, kind of collecting themselves a bit. You never made it back to the feet, man. You could have whipped them a little too easy, man. Oh! Let's be fighting these two guys off right here. Here we go. Look at this powerbomb. Powerbomb to Okada Jr. But look at that. Flip through, and now the Boston Crab is locked in. Boston Crab is locked in. For anyone just tuning in, this is a three-way dance. The ball is recovering on the ramp. And XD and... Oh, wait a minute. Look at that. Smart move on the part of Draven. All right, that's good. I'm going to go for the cover. Uriel putting a stop to that. The Poison Runner. Up in XD on the top of his head. And now, wait a second. Oh, wait a minute. Uriel, that's a DDT. Got him. Caught him with the DDT. Spiking him on the top of his head. And now he got XD right where he wants him. Clothesline. Clothesline again. He's been all over top of his partner, but hey, no sacrifice for the better good. Here we go. Look at this. Oh, jumping clothesline. That's technically a pin, ref. Do your job, bro. I mean, look at it. That's kind of a pain if you ask me. Wait a minute. Oh! Good. I mean, No Limit has isolated and picked apart Draven. Draven might be eliminated. Yes, he is. Wow. Draven is the first elimination in this matchup. XD is the only man remaining for the Ultimate Correction here. No Limit just picked apart Draven. Even in subsequent elimination, and Okada Jr. and Uriel are cooking here. And this one, and there's the cabal. They got to recover themselves here. And oh, and now no minute trying to bring the fight to these guys. I don't think that's the best idea, man, because the cabal, they can ball with the best of them. Dragon suplex there by, oh, man, what a cutter. What a cutter to Wakata Jr. Went right to the midsection. Look at Eldre. Got him up. Ooh, they plant him on the ramp. Out of that field, Okada Jr. Look at this, the networking out of the cabal. Trying to get back in this one. And Draven, the only man out, so technically, I mean, somebody, if they want, they can go off to Mr. XD and don't get him and handle business with him. I guess these guys, these two know what they're doing. They're well aware of this. They're surrounding themselves, but right now, the cabal is doing the dang thing. They get back into this one. Here we go. Oh, and he's right up to the mouth. And Okada of Yorio, the cabal is just cooking here. Back on the inside of the ring. Not a good look at all, man. I mean, now Yorio's in a 2-on-1 spot. That's a forearm there from Meldred. And from Ryan Reyes, Eldred now throwing the combination. And it, ooh, right to the jaw. And they're about to do what No Limit did earlier. They're probably about to take out Yorio and wear him out right here. Yorio might be out of here. No, he's not. But wait a minute. Look at that. Oh! Okada Jr. tried to get in the ring, but got caught up into an uppercut. And now the cabal are rolling. Oh, and a powerball right there on the floor. Down goes Okada Jr. And the cabal again. Oh, man. Flips him down. Look at this. Oh, a combination from Eldrace. Oh, a fifth drop. And now look, they're running to the other side. Looks like they're going to go get XD over there. He's out here on the floor. Yes, they are. Yes, they are. Look at the combination from Ryan Reyes. XD now back in 2-on-1 spot. But colliding the heads of Ryan Reyes and Eldrace. XD doing a dang good thing trying to fight back in this one. His partner's eliminated. First man out. And now Ultimate Correction, now, you know, kind of got to do this thing solo. Here we go, moonsault from XD off the top rope. Beautiful work right there, straight into a cover. Two, gets a two count. He gets a two count, and I will say, it seems that XD got them very, you know, very good at being elusive in this match. We're going to see how long that can last. He did good against the cabal earlier. Looks like he's about to do halfway decent again. XD is fighting to keep two men off of him, and he's doing a pretty dang good job at it. Head scissor taking out Ryan Reyes, and now he can go deal with Eldrace one-on-one. Back elbow right there. Up over to the outside goes Eldrace. Here we go. Look at this. XD taking flight, beautiful. Holy smoke, this XD dude is on. XD got good. XD is freaking cooking. Here we go. Look at this. I'm trying to go for a strike. Didn't work. It's put down. Got after his boys, Draven. I like to use that move as a finisher in his arsenal. But XD going to follow up here. Oh, man, they went head to head. They went head to head. Collided right there. We're talking about an open door for XD. Rolling right into the steel step. Going to get back in the ring. Eldrace makes it back in. And wait a minute. Oh, trying to go for a clothesline. Didn't work. Trying to go for a clothesline. That didn't work. But wait a second. Whoa. Wait a minute. Roll up from XD. He got him with the roll up. Two. Oh, he almost had him. He almost had him. XD trading. Oh, what an uppercut. No Limit still out there on the floor. I got beat up. I got the tail end going by the cabal. But look at this. Oh, look at that. The freaking awareness of this man. He saw Ryan coming in, and instead of going from the dive to XD to Eldrace, he disses to Ryan. Frog left to Ryan. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, but wait a second. Wait a second. Oh, wait a minute. Look at that knee. This dude is moving. This dude is moving. Has this man been jumped before? What is this? That knee is firing off. And the ball got to be all types of frustrated. Ryan Ray finally able to hit this man. But, oh, wait a minute. There he gets put down. Eldre kept him in the net. Forearm, but oh, a clothesline. And that may have shut down the momentum of XD right there. But he was cooking. He was cooking for a moment in the spear on the floor. Oh, great. And I'm looking. There's no limit now trying to collect themselves on the red, man. They tried to take the fight to it. Eldre and Ryan Ritten got smoked recovery, man. Little jumping. Uh-oh. This isn't looking good for XD now. XD may have had a moment of offense. Oh, he caught the bat. He caught the bat. Ryan Ray took the hit. He caught the bat. Ryan Ray took the shot. Look at this. This is incredible. This is freaking incredible. Oh, to the outside. To the outside goes Eldre. And now Ryan Rage is in trouble. Oh, he took a back shot. Now took one right over the top of the head. No disqualification. In a three-way dance. Heck, he knows that. Look at this. Oh, what a combination. Uppercut. XD got him set up. Here we go. Uh-oh. Look at this. Oh, he face plants him. Face plants him. Down he goes. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, wait a minute. XD counters him again. XD counters him again. Are you crazy? This is absolutely crazy. He got him. What elusiveness by XD. That was nuts. That was freaking nuts. That was impressive. That was absolutely impressive. And the beatdown continues. XD with the baseball bat. Eldre is out of here. And he sent Ryan Ray to the floor. What a... Uh-oh. Oh, there's no limit. Get him back in the mix. And they got laid out up on the floor. And collected themselves on the ramp. Stayed out of sight and out of mind of the guys that were in this one. But now, No Limit is the only fresh team in this matchup. Now they got a double team. It's a full-on beatdown to Ryan Rage, who just made it back to his feet. Hurricane Rana to XD. And look at this. Oh, man. Oh, my word. Planting down Ryan Rage. Ryan Rage in a heap of trouble. Look at that. Oh, beat the leg. Beat the leg. And, oh, man. They literally the only, like I said, the only fresh team in this matchup. Draven got eliminated. Draven got eliminated by No Limit. XD pulling off a massive upset, getting an elimination on Eldre with the Cabal. And now they got to deal with the two, basically a 2-on-1 for both teams. The two other teams in this matchup. Look at that. Oh, look at that. No Limit cooking now. Good job from Okada Jr. And now Okada Jr. got XD up over his shoulder. Oh, man. Good sidewalk plan. Down goes XD. Shoulder recover and a kick at it, too. Get the heck out of me. And I grab. Lurio going up top. Oh, XD splash. Horseshoe flat down goes right on top of Ryan Rage. But oh, dropping him. Good grief. He right in the face of XD. Probably knocking him out right there. Wait a minute. Look at this. Turn from Okada Jr. would have wondered why the world would call himself that. I don't think he'd put himself for real like that. But no limit's cooking right now here in this three-way game. They've had no limit. They've probably been one of the more consistent teams in this matchup. I mean, they isolated and they took out Draven quickly. Quickly took out Draven. And ever since then, they tried to fight off the Cabal. That didn't really pan out for them. That was just disrespectful. And that was just absolutely disrespectful. Now you're about to get what you deserve at the hand of Ryan Reeves. Oh, but the GPS, the XD out there on the floor. And now look at this. Oh, he right to the jaw, but Yuri right behind him. Look at Ryan Reeves giving the count. Ryan Reeves doing pulling some elusive strategies of his own. Now we got Uriel solo. This is probably something that was needed here. And look at it. Now we're going to send Uriel to the outside. Wait a minute. Now he's picking up XD. Probably going to get a little bit of revenge for everything. Wait a minute. He's looking out of eye here. Is that using double the line for? And so, Ryan Reeves going to go after Okada Jr. But wait a minute. Oh, look at that. XD with the uppercut. And I guess these two men realize, okay, I mean, we're both down a member. Let's try to work together and try to get one of these guys out of here. And they're jumping Okada Jr. Smart. You got to admire that. Uneasy, you know, sometimes you got to form these type of alliances. And look at this. High low right there. Oh, wait a minute, but look at Yorio. Look at Yorio. XD was spotting him. Here we go. Hurricane Rana taking down Yorio. What an interesting turn of events here. And, oh, what a double cutter to Okada Jr. Excellent. Excellent work. Look at these two just running through their arsenal. These two just running through their arsenal right now. This is great. Great IQ on the part of XD and Ryan Reeves, despite him probably I wouldn't trust him too much. And look, I will say, they never man for himself at the end of the day. I wouldn't trust him too much here, but again, while you got the advantage, while you got the invite, while you got the chance to do that, go ahead and take it. And we're one of these three teams that's still going to do a chance, one of these three teams to go to Mission X here. Oh! Looking at combination from Yorio again, putting him down, but wait a minute. He got him off. Oh, dumped him right on the top of his head. Bumping that neck on that one. And now he's picking up XD, putting him back on the inside of the ring. He's probably telling him, hey, get Okada Jr. Or maybe not. Maybe he's setting him up for his own benefit. But here we go. Look at Ryan Reeves dumping Okada Jr. this time. He dumped Ryan Reeves. Wait a minute. Now we got XD. Looks like he wants him to finish him off. Is he looking like he's sure about this? All right, well. Here we go. Oh, double cutter again. That's Uriel. But Uriel gets put down swiftly. Oh, down he goes. Down he goes, and down goes Okada Jr. Look at that! Excellent IQ on the part of XD and Ryan Reeves to double team. And now Uriel's all by himself now. This isn't a good look at all. Up in the corner. Are they about to double team? I guess Ryan may have... XD may have earned right respect there. Tornado DDT. Shooting star, friend. I think XD earned a little bit of Ryan's respect there. And I think he's showing it in a way of, you know, letting him out and double team the guy. Let's get him out of here. Look at this. Oh! Ryan Reeves and XD are cooking. And they got a little bit of respect, man. I'm saying. Here we go. They might go ahead and get Uriel out of here. Puts him down. And oh, whoa. You can't trust nobody, man. Oh, man. I think Ryan Reeves has played this man like a fiddle. Well, look at that. Stabbing the arm for good measure. I think Ryan Razor played this man like a full-on fiddle. Oh! Right to the knee. And now this isn't looking good, man. He's just beating the snot out of that dude here. Oh! I think Yo-Yo is now weakened enough. Wait a minute. Yo-Yo trying to get involved in this whole thing, and now, oh! He's got to get something there. Let me pan out. These three men kind of standing off with each other. Ryan with a kick to the knee of Yo-Yo. And look at that. Now what? You guys are going to form an alliance here, or they're about to go at it? Okay, I will be careful about that. We saw what happened the last time. It's the current. It may be. Oh, okay, there we go. Getting real on when they got to continue to each other again. I love you in that cutter, don't they? I love you in that cutter. All right, to the back of the head. What you got going to do? And then, double cutter again. He's not just cooking. He's got a mug in his man. Combinate beating the snot out of you. This is what you get for being the fresh team. Get targeted like this. Again. Ryan Ray saying why you don't trust nobody. Oh, man. Ryan Rage taking advantage of the rookie mistake of XD. And XD may be out of this one. XD might be out of this matchup. Yes, he is. And now it's down to two teams. Or is it going to be the Cabal or No Limit? And is it going to be Yo-Yo or Ryan Reyes that wins this one for their team? Yo-Yo calling Ryan up to his feet. Oh, excellent counter from Ryan. Got to the leg. Here we go. Oh! Excellent counter right there on the part of Ryan. Excellent counter from Yo-Yo. Yo-Yo feeling confident. Now I got the snot kicked out of him by XD. Ryan Rage. But he's feeling confident nonetheless. Stomping him out. Let me talk about a shot there. Didn't really work. Forearm taking Ryan to the outside. Here we go. Look at Yo-Yo taking flow. Oh, he tried to. Tried to and got absolutely denied. Toss them back on the inside of the ring. And now, this is where things can really turn here. One of these two teams are going to be going to make it back. Is it going to be the, oh, wait a minute. Is it going to be the Cabal? Is it going to be No Limit? Here we go. Oh, what a cross body. Beautiful. Excellent maneuvering by Yo-Yo. To the top he goes. 4-6-30. 6-30. I thought it was a 450, 6-30 splash from Yo-Yo. Oh, and a kick out at 2. This has been good, bro. What a match. Yo-Yo. A counter from Ryan. A counter from Yo-Yo with a forearm. Took them up over his shoulder. Oh, wait a minute. What the world? Oh! Lands them down right over the top of his head and neck. Yo-Yo may have a moment, mate. Yo-Yo may have a chance here. Chop to the chest. That top of the rib dropping Ryan Reed. Look at this. All the way to the corner. Oh, that's a counter right there. Great ball. Oh, beautiful rebound. Excellent rebound from Yo-Yo to the top rope. Four 450. Ryan got the knees up. Kick to the midsection. Kick them. Ah, no, Yo-Yo was ready for that one with the Hurricane Rana. Hurricane Rana by Ryan Reed, or to Ryan Reed. Yo-Yo got him in. Oh, we got him. This one not around the ring post.
Beautiful work, but Ryan get back up to his feet. Ryan immediately get back to his feet. And now, Uriel is in hot water. Uriel is now in hot water. The cutter off the top. Let me Uriel crashing. It might be over. It might be over. Two. Woo. I'll close with that. I'll close with that. Ryan might end this one. Oh, Yo-Yo caught him with a double foot thumb right in the rib. Oh, wait a minute. Look at Ryan immediately rebounding with a knee strike. That's a counter from Ryan. Get caught by your excellent counter. These two guys go around and around. Somebody's gonna take this one home. Excellent counter from Ryan. Oh, shot right to the arm. Look at Ryan, it's shot in the arm again. Gotta go off the rope, but it seems he's kind of drained. Kicked to the back of the leg repeatedly. Out he goes. Out he goes, Ryan Reeves. Continuing with the stomp out the back of the leg. Forearm. An elbow strike. Let's get there. I'm sorry. Elbow strike from Ryan. Ryan is calling him up. Ryan's looking to end this thing. Off the rope. Excellent counter again. Counting him again. Oh, trying to go for that spin kick. Didn't really work. Super kick in the back of the head. That gets countered. Oh! What a shot from Yorio. He right in the face. Boot to the side of the head. Heel kick to the face of Ryan. That might have knocked this man out. That might have knocked this man out to the top. Corkscrew splash from Yorio, kicking him again in the side of the head. And now that hammerlock DDT straight into a cover. No limit is going to miss it at.
Here's what? Your winner, Yorio and Okada Jr., No Limit.
What chaos arose in this main event, but No Limit is going to Mission X to take on the Twisted Disciples for the tag team title. What a performance from both men. What a performance for all teams involved. Limit.
What the? You got to our brother, Colin Kane. You staged an attack on our sister, Carolyn Amber. And now it's time for you two to fade away.
Oh no. Here comes Colin Kane. Here comes Colin Kane. On the apron, and No Limit look like they seen it. Oh no. Oh, man. Furio just got chucked, or Okada Jr. got chucked to the floor. And after the grueling three-way dance, this is not what No Limit needed. The wrath of the Twisted Disciples and Colin Kane with a shot to the midsection. And look at this now. Sending Uriel to the floor. Oh no. Oh no.
that's about trying to break Uriah's back is Colin Kane. And Colin now bouncing Uriah head first off the barricade. I had a feeling when the Twisted Disciple came back, they were going to hit hard. And Colin Kane is hitting extremely hard, beating the brakes off Uriah here. Oh, man, what a forearm. What a forearm from this big man. The Disciple is clearly not the team you want to be playing these type of games with. Oh, no. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, goodness. He's on concrete. Ain't no saving him out there. Uriah is getting destroyed from Colin Kane again. Double choke slam on the floor. Good grief. Uriah that got left in a heap. Same with Okada, who still laid out on the floor. My word. No one need to get some help for these two men. Oh, wait a minute. There's A Stone, and there's JA3. The beatdown. While the Twisted Disciples continue. And A Stone and JA3 gets the jump on these two men. We'll get the jump on Okada Jr. anyway. Good grief. I knew they'd get these two guys weren't going to be playing. Oh, no. Oh, jumping knee strike right there to the head. They thought we're thinking about you and they're still stepping. I think he invited to get the jumping knee strike again from JH3. And now he's setting up A Stone for the broken wheel. Together, that combination is called brain damage. A brain damage combination. And now Okada Jr. is busted open, but he's trying his absolute best to fight back into this, but A Stone is right there with the twisted intention.
Good grief. They split Okada wide open. This is deja vu for no limit here.
They done busted these two men up. They split these, they beat the snot out of these guys. Well, No Limit gets their tag team title opportunity, but it is at the expense of an angry Twisted Disciple. As we say goodnight from Reno.